do that.
How y'all doing?
Ma'am, I'm hanging for old man. I'm even complaining. Since you got a minute to hear.
Retirement celebration. Tonight we are celebrating her 33 years of service in education. We honor Sybil for her work ethic, her gifts, her dedication, her integrity throughout her career as an educator. She has made an impact on countless colleagues and students within the school walls. But not only within the school walls, she's made an impact in our community. Right. And so as she begins this new phase of her life, we want to celebrate all that she has done, and we want to wish her the absolute best in whatever she ventures into next, right? I think we can all agree that there's so much going on in the world, and we're all just trying to navigate the ups and downs, the twists and turns of life, right?
Right.
And Sybil said something to me last week, actually. She said, in the midst of it all, she's making a conscious effort to choose joy.
All right.
She's choosing joy. And so tonight, we invite all of you to choose joy.
Yeah.
We're going to choose joy tonight. We're going to have fun. We're going to cherish this time together and love on each other.
Yeah.
So tonight, we're going to do in Sybil fashion, right? Like only she can. We're going to pray and give thanks to God.
Amen.
We're going to eat.
Yeah.
Because, you know, she loves her food.
Amen.
And we're gonna dance tonight.
Right. Yeah.
All right?
Amen.
So next, help me welcome Lakertria Clay to give our introduction. Thank you.
Amen.
All right, so I am up to introduce Miss Sybil White Taylor. Ms. Sybil White Taylor is a 33-year veteran educator.
Yeah, yeah.
She earned her bachelor's degree in education from Centenary College in 1990, and she completed her master's degree from Louisiana State University in Shreveport, Louisiana. She started her career in 1990 as a fifth grade English language arts teacher at the Johnson Elementary. She transitioned to Mansfield Elementary School when the new school was built. She taught fourth and fifth grade English language arts and social studies for 24 years. She became National Board Certified in 2004, which made her the first African-American teacher in DeSoto Parish to earn this title. She became the librarian at Mansfield Elementary where she served for 2 years. When that position ended, she became the music teacher. She was responsible for planning programs such as the annual Christmas program, Veterans Day program, and Black History program. And she was responsible for starting the talent show, which included showcasing local artists such as Jeter Jones and the Jonathan Jewett. She also started the Mansfield Elementary Choir Club, which consisted of 20 to 25 third and fourth graders who sang in every program at the school and also sang at nursing homes and other community programs. She is the wife of Daryl Taylor, and they have four children, DeMontre, Brittany, Brandon, and Kamisha. They also have one godson, Jacoby. They are the proud grandparents to a host of grandchildren, an uncle and aunt to a host of nieces and nephews. I present to you the honoree for tonight, our retiree after 33 years, Ms. Sybil White Taylor.
Good evening, everybody. Come on, we can do better than that. Good evening, everybody. It is so good to see you guys. You look great out there. And to our honoree, you're just simply beautiful. Come on, put your hands together and bless the Lord. We thank God for all of you who have come out on tonight to celebrate and to honor and to render honor to whom honor is indeed due. 33 years dealing with our cheering. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I say 33 years dealing with our cheering. And she did it well. Do we have any educators in the house tonight? Dealing with our cheering. Yeah, yeah. Sister Taylor did it. She's phenomenal. And I'm so grateful that we had an opportunity to have her belong to us to teach our children, to work with our children in DeSoto Parish. We're grateful. Brother Darrell, we're thankful. We want to say thank you to you for loaning her to us. We're grateful to you as well. It's my task on tonight to render the invocation as well as the blessing of the food. And as we prepare to do that, I love what where's Sister Keisha? I think Sister Keisha said a little bit earlier, we choose joy tonight. We choose joy tonight. You know, there's a lot of sadness and sorrow, but tonight we choose joy. But in choosing joy, we want to still remember. We want to remember the daughter of Brother Taylor, Sister Kamisha Whitaker, who passed on this week. We want to ask you at this time, if you just bow your heads for a brief moment of silence, as we celebrate in our hearts her life. Our Father and our God and Lord, we thank you tonight, for indeed you're a good and you're an awesome God. Father, we thank you for this opportunity of being able to call upon you tonight. Tonight, Lord, we just lift up Brother Taylor and his family in their loss. We pray, oh God, that you would continue to comfort him, continue to strengthen him. And even with all that's going on, he's here tonight to celebrate with his bride. And so, Lord, we just pray your blessing upon him, his whole family, oh God. Pray for our honoree tonight, oh Lord, as she comes to the close of one part of her life and enter into another part of her journey. Lord, bless her in a mighty way. You've been so good to everyone here on tonight, and we just thank you for every person that has come to celebrate, who's come to have fun. We pray, oh God, that you will bless our fellowship tonight. We pray that you bless the feast that has been prepared tonight, maybe for the nourishment of our bodies. And Lord, we just thank you for the fellowship. And Lord, when all is said and done, and when we go back to our homes, may we look back with joy in our hearts, thanking you for the night that we've had on tonight. These and many other blessings we ask in the worthy and matchless name of your Son, Jesus Christ. The people of God said, amen.
Miss Sybil White, Daryl, you all can go ahead and start the line for the food and the family. Church members, your food is over there in the back. If you all don't mind, just go by table to serve yourselves as well. And
I would say you are the teacher of a lifetime because you have touched so many lives in and out of the classroom. And I'm so thankful that God allowed our paths to cross. But apart from being such an outstanding educator, Sybil, I just want to thank God for the person you are. You are truly a God-fearing woman. You are a woman who is full of compassion. You are a giving spirit. And you are a genuine person. And for this, I am so thankful. You know, 2 years ago, you offered your support to me during a time when, I mean, it was just a turbulent time for me. But you reached out to me, and that support that you extended to me really left an impression on my heart to this day. You didn't have to do it, but you did. And I thank you so much. I love you. I applaud you. I salute you. I congratulate you, and I say moving forward, I pray that God will continue to bless the works of your hands. Welcome, Sybil Taylor, to the retirement club. There is no place like you. Congratulations.
Clay says I have 2 minutes, so I'm going to stick to it. Good evening, everybody. I'm Debbie Fuller. And the beautiful thing that I have to say is that I don't just know Sybil as one of my teachers. I know Sybil as one of my very best friends in the whole wide world. So 30 years ago, I came to Mansfield to marry that handsome man right there that's taking the victory, right? And I met him actually at Sybil's house. And so the first thing I can say about Sybil is that she is one of the most hospitable people in the world. Hospitality Hotel is her house, right? So I became principal right after Ms. Spears, who was a mentor to all of us. And one of the things that Sybil likes to do is be a little bit fashionably late to work. Did y'all know that? She likes to be fashionably late. But when I became principal, and because I was her best friend, she chose to be on time to Montreal early. You hear me? Because she didn't want me to have to write her up. You hear me? Sybil was such an amazing teacher. My first year that we started TAP, Sybil made more money than I did. Her bonus was the highest in the school. That is, I don't even know if you know that, Sybil, but because she worked so hard, her scores were so high, she and LaCurtria had the best scores in town. But Sybil's scores caused her to have a higher bonus than the principal. So that just is a testament to the kind of effort and work that she made. Now, I'm at one point she got a little burned out, right? So I decided to make Sybil a music teacher. And as you can see, She finished her career as one and has changed and turned Mansfield upside down with the work that you have done in that classroom. So thank you, Sybil. Now, as her friend, y'all know Sybil can talk. You think I can talk? Sybil can talk. How many times at the end of the year did we leave Mansfield Elementary? Last day of the year, we would go get our nails done, go shopping, go whatever, whatever. So we're passing, we're coming 171, I think it is. And how many times, Sybil, did you pass the road because you were talking? Like, took me to her house. Like, skip by the forest, take me straight to her house. We're in the driveway before she realizes she has to take me home. Every year on end, never ended, which lets you know I'm the perfect driver, right? I'm the one who can real, everybody knows that I am the best driver in town, but she didn't want me to drive. She always wanted to drive. So all I can say is if you were in Sybil's class, Sybil was your favorite teacher. Now, the last thing I'm gonna say, and I know my 2 minutes are climbing, how many times, you know, look at me, look at Sybil, I'm about 7 shades darker than Sybil, right? Everywhere I go, I'm Miss White. Miss White, you know, we used to do the Marvel job. Miss White, you know, we used to go on a movie with, baby, my name is Miss Fuller. No ma'am, you Miss White. Baby, my name is Miss Fuller. Oh, you don't remember that time we Miss White, come on now. Okay, yeah, baby, that's right, we did that. One of my greatest pleasures is being my best friend, Miss White Taylor. So guys, let me say this. Because of Sybil, so many of us are blessed. It's not just in the classroom, but outside of the classroom. Look at the beauty of our church family, the beauty of friends, the beauty of school. Sybil, your life has touched so many. Your legacy will live on long after we're gone. I love you with all my heart and a big part of my liver.
I am trying to behave up here. Good evening, everyone. My name is Malika Celine Morgan. And before I met Sybil at Mansfield Elementary, you may not believe this, but I had heard a lot about her from Debbie Fuller. I met Debbie years ago before I came to Mansfield, and we immediately became best friends. But then she started talking about this other best friend, Sybil. And in my mind, I'm like, she probably is not all of that. So when I got here in 2011, guess what? I met Mrs. Sybil Nadine White, now Taylor, and she was everything that Debbie K. Fuller said she was and more. So when I think of Sybil, and Debbie's gonna love this one, I think of scripture. Proverbs 3 verses 5 through 6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. That's what I see. Sybil has gone through things while at Mansfield Elementary, but she maintained the trust, whether it's been personal struggles, professional struggles, Sybil always trusted in the Lord. And that's what I will take with me. That's what I will remember. She has been amazing, an amazing part of my life, the life of my children. She taught, I think, two of them, and they love her. One wants to come live with her. I'm like, Sybil gone. And they refer to her as Sybil White is the OG, because she did not play with them, and they loved and appreciated that. So, Sybil, from the bottom of my heart, from the Morgans, we love and appreciate you, and we pray that God continues to bestow his mighty blessings upon you.
All right. Good evening, everyone. I'm not as bubbly as these two ladies, but I want to talk to Sybil tonight about something that I saw when I first got down there. Zora Neale Hurston once said that there are years that ask questions and years that answer. For those of us who have worked in DeSoto Parish, know that we've all had years where we've had more questions than we've had answers. For years, the questions, the uncertainty, the misinformation, the mistreatment have left us like a box of Rice Krispies ready to snap, crackle, and pop. But the one thing that has remained the same throughout all those years has been Sybil White Taylor. When we have had more questions than answers, all of us at some point or another have looked to Sybil to be our answer. It has been you, Sybil, voluntarily leading the charge, stepping up, stepping out, speaking up on our behalf about the things that matter to us the most. It has been your sacrifices, your shoulders, your refusal to remain silent that have given educators like us the strength to stand and call out wrong when we too see it. Thank you, Sybil, for being a trailblazer in education. Thank you for your tireless efforts. Thank you for your model of excellence. Thank you for your years of endurance. But most of all, to my friend, thank you for your endless encouragement. Because of the seeds you've sown and the sacrifices you've made, our hope tonight, our prayer, our wishes for you is that the God who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think will bless you greatly in your retirement years. We love you, we're grateful for you, and we honor you tonight. Thank you for your service. Larry, Malika, you would like to say sing something?
I'm not gonna sing. That's the only negative thing about Sybil. She would never put me on any program. Even though her students told her I could sing, she refused to let me. But other than that, she's been amazing.
We will now hear from some of her former students, Aisha Lane and Marcelia Jackson.
So I'm going to go first, and also I will be speaking on the behalf of Lakeisha Fair. We were, let me get closer. Can y'all hear me? Okay. So we were both in Sybil's fourth grade classroom in roughly, I think, about 2003, 2004. I'm 30 now, so that's saying a lot. That's saying a lot. I survived, okay? I survived fourth grade. I'm still breathing. I have all my limbs. But in fourth grade, one of my fondest memories, Miss Sybil White at the time, had a marble jar. And the marble jar was about this big, this wide, and the marble was the size of a dime.
Come on, somebody.
So you would have to, this is how it went. Like, so it's a reward system. So you would have to be good, you had to do all your tests, you had to be quiet just to get by two marbles in this big old jar. Two marbles. So I'll say out of 365, about around 364, you finally had a popcorn party. We worked this hard for a popcorn party. And it's not like we got our own bag of popcorn. No, we did not get our own bag of popcorn. We got the brown paper towels out of the bathroom that was free. And she'll put it on your desk and get three bags of popcorn. She's gonna pop them. It's gonna smell all through the hallway. Everybody wants popcorn. Shake the bag on a little paper towel. One bag went around the whole class. Now y'all know what that is. One bag went around the whole class. It's about, oh, if y'all be good, y'all can get some more. You know? So we worked hard, and I think at that time popcorn probably was $2. So we worked that hard for a six count pack of box of popcorns, only to receive one real pack of popcorn. So at the time we didn't understand. We were just so happy just to eat popcorn with no juice, nothing but the water from the fountain, you know? So I never departed with that memory. I was so grateful. I never sweat so hard in my life. I never was so quiet to receive a marble. So I thank you so much for teaching us how to go through life, how to strive for excellence, and how to receive the marbles, you know, because it pays off. And I also have the pleasure of doing her hair now. I get to see her in different phases of life, and it has been a pleasure. Lakeisha Fair has the opportunity to work beside her in education. So thank you for being a small part of our journey. You have truly been a blessing to ours.
Hello.
I was informed to be nice, so that's what I'm going to do. But I've been waiting 30 years for this. But no, in real life, the marble jaw had a chokehold on us, y'all. And she would give you them two marbles, but if you did one thing bad, you could have stepped out of line like, dude, she took 15. So your little two meant nothing if you did something wrong. But we used to be like, do something wrong in the hallway and we get marbles taken away, we gonna beat you up at the park. So it had our whole class in a chokehold, but we got more than one bag of popcorn. We got like to bring our own snacks and we got the popcorn. But Sybil is the reason I like to read. She used to make us read books, and if we finished the book and we could tell her what the book was about, we got marbles. Y'all see how this is playing? Yeah, okay, great. So we got marbles and we read The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Y'all read this book? Okay, so there's a treat in there called Turkish Delight. Sybil decided the greatest thing to do would be to make this in the classroom, a classroom full of fifth graders. And just so you can have reference, Turkish Delight is salted jello with powdered sugar. It was the nastiest thing. We was all so excited, but it was so disgusting. So, off of telling you how she tortured us in fifth grade, I have two really good memories of you. One of them being, I got trapped in my jacket one day because I was playing in class, and Sybil wouldn't help me out. She left me in the class, in front of everybody with my hands like this, in my jacket. And she said, if you're gonna play in class, you're gonna sit in class and look crazy. And I said, cool, because that means I ain't got a right, right? So then she made me go outside. So we had to have a conversation. But she told me in that conversation, she was like, you play so much. Why you play so much? Why? Like, she just kept asking me like why I was always doing stuff. And I told her that I was afraid to not be liked or afraid to not, you know, have friends. And it's something that stuck with me so much that I put it on my walls. I also got it tattooed on me. Sorry, Mom. But she told me, just because you're afraid of something don't mean you can't do it. It don't mean you can't go forward, right? So I was like, wait. Because, you know, at 10, I don't know what you're talking about. But it stuck with me even now at almost 40. You had me as a class, I was 10. But it stuck with me. And so I live by the motto, and I tell my kids the motto, like, hey, be afraid, but do it anyway. Because on the other side of fear, you know, is triumph. Like, once you get past your fear, you can do anything. And I learned that from Sybil. And also, it's raining outside, right? For me, rain means growth. It means the birth of something. And just because you're ending your career here as a teacher does not mean that you don't have something to grow into. So I hope that the rains today water you and help you grow into the woman that you want to be in retirement. And I just want you to know that I love you and thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Now we will have a special presentation from the class of 1986. Taylor, as this chapter of your life ends, may a new and exceptional one begin.
Congratulations on your well-deserved retirement after years of outstanding and dedicated service. May the blessings of good health, the joy of good friends and loving family, the commitment of a job well done, fill your life with happiness. Best wishes. Thank you from your friends, the class of MHS 1986, for your 33 years of service.
Everyone, I can hear y'all. Good evening, everyone. Yeah, there we go. I have just been having a wonderful time tonight, just seeing all these smiling faces, all the people who have touched my life. I'm so grateful for these 33 years, and I'm grateful for how God has guided me all throughout those 33 years. And I ain't done yet. I ain't done yet, y'all. I'm not going to teach anymore, but I'm not done doing some other things. I will be moving to Dallas in July. Calm down, Demontre. Demontre, I think I'm going to keep a little cheering for him when I move out there all the time. I love my girl, but he ain't finna put a cheering on me every day. He's trying to put him over every day, y'all. Look at him. He knows what he's up to. I know what he's up to. But I get a chance to move in with my handsome husband. We've been back and forth for some years now, and God has blessed us, and so we can finally be here under one roof. So thank you for being patient with me, Daryl. I love you. I want all of my family to please stand up. Family, please stand. I have so many family members who have driven from out of town. Let's give them a big hand, everybody. My nieces and nephews, I'm so grateful, family. I love you all. Thank you so much for all of your support. Thank you. You may be seated. I want all of my classmates to stand up again. Class of 86. Y'all, we are so close. I love my classmates. They are like family to me, and they have always been there for me, and I like to be there for them. We just love on each other. We support each other. Thank you all so much for just going on this journey with me. I taught a lot of their kids, and so thank you all for the support. I need my co-workers to stand, Mansfield Elementary co-workers, even the retired folks. Stand up, Sharon Slacks. I'm retired. Thank you so much, Mr. Davis. I'm so excited he came. Mr. Davis has been retired for a while now. He rubs it in my face, y'all, whenever I see him. So I'm retired like you now, Mr. Davis. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. I need all of my friends to please stand. All of my friends at the friends table, please stand. Thank you all so much for coming. So many that came from the Dallas area. Thank you so much for supporting tonight. And last but not least, I need my church family, Memorial SDA Church. Right, stand up. Yeah. They had to have their own section, but they so loud, y'all. But that also, but we're my biggest group, because I wanted all of my church family to be here. One thing I have to say is when I transitioned to becoming the music teacher, I was nervous about it when Debbie asked me if I wanted it. She was my principal at the time. And Sister Debbie, I appreciate you allowing me to do it. I was nervous about it. But one thing that Stephanie Lee told me, she said, well, you know what to do. Oh, Super White, you know what to do, Super White. You've been doing programs at the church all these years. You just do what you do at the church. Just do it at the school. And she was right. And so I did, that was my training ground. I realized that that was my training ground. I learned how to do programs and to teach children to sing at the church. So when I left the classroom, it was an easy transition for me because God had already prepared me so for that. And I don't think I would have made it to these 33 years had I not done that. I was so tired at year 24. I needed to do something different. So I'm grateful that I was in the classroom, but I'm also grateful that I was able to be the music teacher for the last 7-8 years. And I'm just so thankful, y'all. Just so thankful. I just like to praise God for all he has done for me. And thank you all so much for coming. And now it's time to party. Before we do that, I just want to thank my good friends and my hostesses, Miss Keisha Cooper. I love you, Keisha Cooper. Miss Lakertria Clay, she's so bossy, y'all. She helped me pull this thing together. Thank you, Lakertria. I love you. And Deborah, where are you, Deborah? There she is. Thank you, Deborah. And Danita, ooh, she's so bossy, trying to tell me what to do all night. Thank you, Danita. It's my roll doll right there, y'all. Want to thank Miss Mineola's creation. Wasn't the food good, y'all? Miss Mineola, you know I love you. Anything I do, I'm getting you to do it for me. Thank you so, so much. Aren't the decorations beautiful, you all? Chastity outdid herself. Is Chastity in the room tonight still? Has she been tipping out? I just want you all to show Chastity some love because I didn't worry her. I said, look, you do whatever you do, and she outdid herself. Chastity, thank you. If you can hear me, thank you so much. It is beautiful. Y'all show her some more love, please. And I want to thank Brother Steve for doing the slideshow and the video and taking pictures and everything. I love you, Steve. Steve-O. All right. Steve and I and Richard, we can't hear very well, so we have to do a lot of sign language for each other. Y'all pray for us. Don't talk about us. Pray for us. All right. Now, we are in the hands of one of the greatest bands in the country. Musicology and my boy, Jonathan Jewett.
All right, let's give it up for it one more time. So she said, we're celebrating tonight. Y'all come to celebrate with me soon. Did y'all come to celebrate with us tonight? All right. So we're going to party like it's 1999. Y'all ready to say yeah? Let's go. Come on, hey. Hey, I'm so in love with you. Whatever you want to do, come on, it's all right with me. Thank you.
tonight. Something better make you go wrong than make you go right.
say yeah if you're ready to point us some more. Let's go. Thank you. breath. So once y'all get back to your seat, I'm gonna need your voice. Ladies, y'all in the building tonight? All right. Y'all gotta help me sing this one right here. Y'all ready?
Be more clever, a woman to reach down this
How y'all feeling out there? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Y'all ready for some more good music? Let me hear you say yeah. Y'all give it up for my girl, Miss Darryl. Y'all make some noise.
Where I dream now.